record now. Sound good? All right. Then we have a bunch on monitors. Now, two of the chapters that are probably the most in-depth technically are the chapters on video and the one on printers. Boy, they really go off the deep end on that. But if that's what you're being tested over, that's what you need to know. So what was the type of monitor we used before we had flat panels? Anybody? Waiting.
CRT.
Yes. Who is that?
Jason.
Yes. And
yeah,
how old are CRTs?
This is my, we don't have a lab tomorrow because he got new equipment. He's setting it up. So we're having a Zoom meeting right now, but I emailed him and I said,
hello, can you hear me? I'm on. Yeah. The CRTs were basically after the first television, which was basically the 1920s, if you can believe that. They were more mechanical. They worked. The flat panels, I was there when they built the first ones. It was incredible. You could see the wires in the screen, and they made them smaller and smaller, and they used different technologies. So it's pretty interesting. Okay. Let's see. They'll talk a little bit about how flat screens work, just some general stuff. They really get into the weeds in terms of the active and passive. Make sure you look at that. Let's see. And then what terms do you use to describe monitor? Well, let's think about it. We have the monitor itself, so we're going to look at the pixels. If we have a projector, we're going to look at the throw, we're going to look at the lumens, etc. Be familiar with those terms. That's going to be important when you go to purchase these things. Okay. Ooh. And yeah, pretty much covers that. And then chapters on networking, internet, etc. You're going to take a whole series of classes on that. So I don't get in the weeds on that, but some of the really important stuff I go into. For instance, can you contrast IP version 4 versus 6? What's the biggest difference? Anybody say it in one word?
Hexadecimal.
Seth, that's perfect. My God, my heart soars like an eagle. Tears of academic joy. Why did we have to go to hexadecimal?
Because we start to run out of binary numbers.
Yes. Can you imagine that? We had no idea the internet would get so big. We thought maybe 10% of the population would use it. Oh, we are wrong. Okay. How many of you know the difference between an RJ45 and an RJ11? How many of you have crimped an RJ11 versus an RJ45?
One is a phone line and the other one is a Ethernet cable.
How many wires in both?
The RJ45 has 6, I believe.
8.
8. Yeah.
That's okay. And then the RJ11, it can have anywhere from 2 to 4. You know, we started off with 2 and then a ground and then 3. So very good, very good. And the cat levels. Now, how many different cat levels are there? Where are we at right now? Well, most of us are
working. You get cat eight, I think we are.
That's the high speed. Most of us are working off of Cat 5 or Cat 6 cable, but that's going to change quickly as we go from the current internet speeds up into the gigabit range. We're all going to be working with the Cat 6, etc. AT&T is out in my neighborhood constantly doing bad things to everybody else's internet, so they usually break it. Okay, so beware of that. Let's see. And how many bits are in a MAC address? That's always a test question. Anybody?
48.
Yes, Frank. You guys actually read this. My heart soars like an eagle. Okay. All right. Now, an IP address stands for what?
Internet protocol.
Right. And what's it made up of? What's one word that would describe it? Starts with an O. Octet, right?
Yes.
And important. Okay. So be aware of what a default gateway is. How many of you have used the keyboard command traceroute? Trace RT. You done that in your network class yet? You will.
That just pings a server and it tells you how where it bounced around on the internet, basically.
Yeah, I found out that my website was hosted in Canada. What are they thinking, sending me to Canada? They took away my beer, made me leave the beach. They have a little bit different standards in Canada and Texas in terms of drinking the beach. But let's not go over that nightmare. What are the wireless standards? What's the overall standard for wireless? I believe. And versions, are you ready? A, which was not the first one out, which was B. Then we had G. Then we had N, AC, and I don't know what they've got now, but they all got
AX. It's AX now, AX.
Oh, yeah. And it's blazing fast, isn't it? And with 5G, I'm not sure. It's not included in this book, but I would know about 5G, and that will probably be something you'll encounter at the workplace. Let me see if I can find some information on that, okay? Then, how far does wireless go? It kind of depends on the wireless you're using, right? You're either dealing with 2.4 gigahertz or 5 gigahertz. If you're dealing with Bluetooth versus Wi-Fi, etc., if you're having it in a building, you have to worry about objects bouncing around, repeaters, etc. Anybody here have a area in your house that's not good? I got a repeater because the only place the kids could really get a good internet connection was in the bathroom that my mother-in-law uses, which made for some really tense moments. Things were happening. Okay. And Bluetooth. What was the first use of Bluetooth? Anybody tell me? Changed my life. Remote controls. Who invented Bluetooth? I believe it was Hedy Lamarr, World War II, for some reason. And before we had remote controls, we had something called children, and we would make them change the stations. And if you went too far, you used one curse word. If they didn't go far enough, you used another curse word. So televisions and remote controls were traumatic items. Okay, now that's it in a nutshell. If you can get that, you should do pretty good. I will post those questions onto Blackboard. I will not give you answers, but you heard a lot of them today. So we're not doing rocket science since I cover so much area with 100. Then after this week, we will have lab next week, even though we're having a test. We have 7 more weeks left and things that we're going to cover. We're going to stick with one hard drive. I may go in and gin some up for you, but we're going to deal with, let's see, users, security, virtual machines, and we're going to do a virtual machine for almost everything so that you know what you're looking at when you encounter it. So a couple of ways of doing it. In the old days, I would have everybody load all the software on. I'll have you load one virtual machine. I think I'm going to use Oracle Virtual Box. It seems to work pretty well on our machines. And then I'm simply going to show you how to load them from files, how to import and export them, which is pretty common. Okay. And then, let's see. We have one lab on wireless applications. Should be fun. I think we'll do wireless, crimping, and electricity all in one. I want to show you all the gadgets that I have so that you'll know how to use them should time come up. And then, let's see. Of course, we've got our Raspberry Pis. Now, this is kind of fun, and I have a standing offer. If you can come up with a unique application for a Raspberry Pi that I can use in my trade shows, I will give you a half a grade. Sound like a plan? Anyway, it has to be usable, but I found that's pretty good. Last year, I had the gentleman who actually did quite well. He used a Raspberry Pi to sense the temperature inside a beehive and then activate a fan when the beehive got too hot. I don't know if you're aware of it, but the...
Wait, so what did you want us to do the Raspberry Powder project for?
I'll let you anything that you want to.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah, and this is extra credit or another assignment?
But it will be on any one of the tests that you're taking. It will be an additional half a grade.
Gotcha.
So will that be acceptable?
Yes, indeed.
That will be great. Okay. So having said that, what else do I have? Now, the last week, week 16, is just makeup. So we got, so this is week 9, really. So we've got about 6 weeks left. So we'll have 6 more experiments. They won't be quite as jumbled. And I really appreciate the hard work and dealing with all the equipment laying around. I mean, I'm in new ground. This is a brand new area for me. I had to go through the disinfecting protocols with my students. They, just like you, they've done quite well. Okay, well, that's what I got coming up next week. I'll go ahead and post the questions that I went over with you onto Blackboard. And then I will put this out on Blackboard also. And I'll open it for questions, et cetera, right now.
So on Monday, I had an emergency situation with my dog where he stopped breathing. I emailed you about it. Luckily, he's okay now, but I had to spend the entire time at the vet and everything. So I didn't make class. And every time I tried to log into the Zoom meeting that day, for some reason, it just kept saying.
That's okay, Nick. Tell you what, we'll set up a little makeup date. We can get by that, okay?
That'd be great. I really appreciate that.
Oh, wait. Was this the Monday class on the 19th?
No.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Anybody else?
Oh, yeah. Professor?
Yes.
How many more labs do we have for the rest of semester? We got 7 weeks, but I'm not sure how many labs.
To get at least 4.
Labs. At least 4.
At least 4. Mm-hmm. Plus,
got it. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Anybody else?
I also have, because I didn't realize this is sent out, I have a class that goes from 6 to 9 for a Unix. Uh-huh. It's also online. I can easily do both, but just I was able to get out of it early today due to me finishing the project already.
This is, I've usually been doing these at 3, but since I now have the class all 4 days a week that are in the afternoons, I'm not able to do that anymore.
Oh, it's no worries. It just, I might be slow in responding to things because I'll be listening to 2 videos at the same time.
Okay, Nick, but you got your pants on, right?
Oh, yeah.
All right, dude, that's all, it's important. I usually have my kids sneaking up here trying to grab my car keys. He went and bought 2 cars, neither of which worked, so he's borrowing mine nonstop and using all the gas. But he is my son, so if you see me choking somebody, it's my son.
Good to know.
Sound good? Okay. Anybody else?
I have a... Actually, never mind.
You there, Seth?
Yeah, I had a question, but then I realized what the answer was, so never mind.
Sounds good. I like the self-answering questions. That means your brain is on fire, unlike mine, which is just about 20 seconds away from hitting the pillow. Okay, anybody else? You guys have been doing really good, and I really appreciate the hard work, attendance. It's a pleasure and honor to have students dedicated enough to come during difficult times. This is where you build character, okay? Well, I will go ahead, unless somebody wants to talk with me, sign off. I will post this meeting on Blackboard, and I will send you a list of the topics that I covered for the review. Sound good?
Sounds good. Do you want me to just email you about the stuff from Monday so I can
sure.
get caught up?
If you would.
Awesome. I'll shoot you an email.
Sounds good.
Thank you, Professor.
Last question.
All right. Oh, yeah. Yes, Seth.
All right. So you said earlier there's an essay during the exam. So how long will that be?
Couple roughly. It's more of a text answer. It's not a big
great.
I figure I'm running you over the coals anyway. Why make it worse? Okay. Thank you, Seth. Anybody else?
Professor, about the essay, is it going to be over a specific chapter of the book, or it's from
11 through 21?
11 through 21?
Yep.
Okay. Thank you.
You bet. Have a good night.
You too. Thanks.
And a wonderful night to all of you. It's supposed to get cool. I'll know because my wife will have all the covers and I'll wake up shivering. It's a rite of passage each year. All right. Stay safe, guys. And we'll see you next week. Same time, same place.